So far, we learned how we can create a list item or create a record in any data source. It doesn't matter what, we are following exactly the same logic. So basically, the way that these actions are designed is very consistent across the board. So we learned how to create an item. We learned how to query and find the item. Now it's time to update those items or delete those items. Let's see how it is done. To update or delete, you must have the item ID. There is no way around it. If you don't have the item ID, you need to look it up. So let's see how we can delete or update a list item by having the ID. Just like before, I go to flow.microsoft.com and I want to create a new flow. Again, the easiest one, I want to create an instant flow, manually trigger a flow, and I want to say delete or update flow. Manually trigger a flow, I click on create, and the flow is created. As I told you before, I need the ID, so the first parameter that I want to pass to this flow is the ID of the item that I want to delete or update. So I pick number and I say ID. And we start by deleting an item. So let's say SharePoint. And under SharePoint, I look for delete item. Of course, you can delete the file exactly the same way, but let's delete the item. And I need to look up the site URL, Power Automate Workshop. If you don't have it, again, just like before, scroll down, click on Enter Custom Value, and copy and paste the URL. Now, let me go back to SharePoint and show you what I'm cooking here. I want to create a flow that when the button is pushed, it comes down and deletes one of the items here based on the ID. In this example, I want to delete the SD card, and that SD card has the ID 6. So when I run the flow, I should enter the 6 as the ID. And if everything goes well, I expect that flow delete the very last record inside SharePoint. So the list name is product list demo. I go back to the flow tab. I look up the products list demo. And the ID should come from manually trigger a flow, which we will see it here. Click, we got it, and this one will delete. Let's give it a shot. So I say test, select the first item, test, continue, and now I need to provide an ID. Again, verify ID was 6. So if I come here and enter the ID 6, and I click on run flow, done. It completed successfully. And if I go back here, if I refresh the page, that record is gone. What if I enter an ID that does not exist there? Let's give it a shot and see what will happen. So this time, again, I test it and I enter an ID that does not exist, like for example, 200. Let's run the flow. And I click on done. And you see, it creates an error. The flow fails because it cannot find it. So you must have the ID. If you don't have the ID, the flow fails. So there are two ways around it. One way, either use get items, search for that ID and make sure that item exists, or right away try to delete the item and then check if any error happened. At the moment, I don't want to get into that. In the future chapters, we go through all these exceptions and how we can handle that. But just keep in mind that it assumes that you already have the correct ID. So we saw an example of delete. Let's see an example of update. So for the update, I really don't need this delete item anymore. So I just remove it. And now I need to add a new action under SharePoint list, and I need to add update. I can click on update item, and just like before, I pick up the list from the site, products list demo. Now, you see, as soon as I pick the list, it shows me all the fields that they are available under that list. So I need to provide the values for title, category value, and unit price. So let's start with something simple. For example, for one product here, microwave, the title is wrong. I want to correct the title. So just like this, I go back to the flow designer. I expand this. In addition of ID, I want to add title here. So the user will enter the ID and the title, and the flow should go to the SharePoint list, find the item with this ID, and update the title with the value that the user provides. So the ID will be the ID that comes from the trigger, and the title, again, comes from the title under trigger. There we go. So far I have the ID and title, category value and unit price. If I just leave them blank, flow will not change them. So assumption is that if you provide the value, it will replace the existing value. If you don't provide anything, flow will just ignore it. Good. So let me save it and give it a shot. So for this one, the item with the ID 2, the title should become microphone. Let me see if I can correct that. Let me save and test the flow. And this time it's asking me for the number. The ID was 2. And the title should be microphone. And I click on run flow. Done. Successful. Let's go here and see what happened. Great. So the title has changed, but the category and unit price did not change. Great. I couldn't ask for more. So far it was pretty easy. Provide ID, provide the title, and ignore the other fields. It just goes there and updates one single field. What if I want to update category only? For example, we just realize that the Rubik's Cube that we have is the new generation electronics timer and all those things with it. And all of a sudden, we want to put it under electronics. Let's see if it is as easy as we expect. Let's get back here. And for the update item, let me go to edit. This time, I don't need to change the title. I just need to change the category. And I want to set it to electronics. So basically, I want to say, when I run the flow, whatever the ID is, go look it up and set the category to electronics. Do not change the title. Do not change the unit price. Now, here is the problem. Because inside SharePoint, title is a required field, this one says, hey, I'm not going to let you even save it because you have to provide the title. And no matter how many times I try to make this guy understand that I do not want to change the title, let it be the way it is, Flow does not understand. Great. So how can we handle this part? That's where we need to actually look up this item and read the original title and put it back in place again. So basically for this one, we really don't need the title. And we really don't have the title. We just have the ID, and maybe we want to add another text, like, for example, category. So the user will enter the ID and the category, right? But we need to pick up the existing title and provide it to the update item because this guy, this action requires the title. How do we do that? You guessed it right. Again, we go to SharePoint, SharePoint get item or items. Obviously, we have the ID, so we can use the get item. So get item is added here. Again, we go to the same site. We go to the same list, products list demo. We get the ID from the trigger. Great. Now, after we get the item, we can provide the ID from the trigger, but we can provide the title from the previous action, which is the get item, because get item reads the existing title and we just provide the same thing. I totally understand. It sounds like a silly, unnecessary step that we need to add here, but sorry, this is the way it works. Let me just save it and let's test it. So the flow should accept the ID and the category, and whatever the product that we provide the ID, it should set the category to what we provide here, and it shouldn't change anything else. So let me just test it. So we want to change the product ID number 4 to electronics. So we provided the ID, we provided the title. Now we just need to provide the category. Instead of hard coding it, we can get it from the trigger, which is simple. Click on this dropdown, click on enter custom value, put the mouse here. All we need to do, we need to get the category from the manually trigger a flow from the trigger button, which is going to be the category. There we go. Now let's save it and test it. Test. Now the product that we want to change is going to be number 4. And the category is going to be electronics. And I click on run flow. Done. And if I go back to Power Automate, you'll see that the category is changed to electronics. So we learned that we must have the ID to delete or update the list item. You may have noticed that we can delete or update one item at a time. There is no such a thing as like batch delete or batch update inside Power Automate. There are ways to do it indirectly, but built-in actions inside Power Automate do not do that. And finally, if you don't have the ID, search for the items using get items and use the returned ID to update or delete the desired list item. Let me give you an example. So imagine instead of ID, someone wants to provide the title of the product, and then we need to update the unit price. So in this case, we don't need category and we don't need ID. If I click on this, you see that we cannot remove it. So I need to go to the update item and get rid of these two values. Under get item, again, I need to get rid of this ID, and then I will be able to delete them. Okay. So now for this one, I want to provide a field called title. And I also need to provide another field, which is going to be unit price. So in this case, I do not have the ID coming from the trigger. I have the title. I want to find the title and I need to update the unit price based on the values that the user enters. If you remember from the previous lecture, if you don't have the ID, get item does not do the trick. Let's get rid of it. And now instead of get item, we need to use get items. So SharePoint, select get items, right? And again, site address, we look it up, Power Automate Workshop, list, product. products list demo. I don't need any limitations because I just need the ID. The only thing that I need to filter for title equals, and that equal should be in the single quote. The only thing is that I get the value from the title that comes from the trigger here. So this is how it should look like. Title equals the value that the user enters. Great. So basically get items finds all the items that they have that specific title. Because the titles are unique, we know that this one returns only one item. But even if it returns more, you got to be careful because this flow should update anything that has this title. Get item returns either nothing or one, or may return more based on the content, because nobody guarantees the uniqueness of the title field. Although in this example, title is unique. So let's get back here. And now, after we get the items, we need to update the item, and the ID comes from the get item. Remember, get item can remember more than one record. So if I scroll down here, if I look up the ID from get items, again, update item will be enclosed in an apply to each because it should run this action for every single item that comes from the get items. We know that it returns either one or no records, but Flow doesn't know the data content. So I just pick up ID, and you see all of a sudden my update item is inside an apply to each. So basically, update item will run for every single item that get items returns. Expand. So I got the ID. Remember, we were not supposed to change the title, but title is required. So now we can get the title from get items. So we have the title. The unit price is going to be what the user provides in the trigger form. So again, I scroll down here and I find the unit price from the trigger. Just make sure that the cursor is here. Click on unit price, and this is how it looks like. Let's review it again. So user enters the title and unit price. Because we do not have the ID, we use get items using an OData query to look up every item that has that specific title, which hopefully it will return one. And then after we get that, we can use the update item. And now update item has the ID that it requires. Also, it requires to re-enter the title because title is a required field in this action. And eventually it will assign the unit price that we provided. Let's see. Save. Let me run the test. I'll perform the trigger action, test. Now we want to change the unit price of the laptop to maybe 99.95. Probably it's an open box and a special promotion. Let me click on Run Flow. Done. It says it completed successfully. Let's examine it here. Apply to each has only one record. And if I go back here, you will see my laptop is $19.95. And I guess by now we have gone through almost every possible scenario that can happen when we try to update records.